Hi guys, I'm here with another video, just kind of giving you an update on my transition. I'm again wearing a headband. This is actually my favorite one. I love this one. I just came in from going jogging, so my hair is completely sweated out, which is why it's gonna be pulled back for today. And the biggest update I want to give everyone was the fact that I have now been transitioning for about 7 weeks. I've passed the point of when I would have got a touch-up, so I'm very excited that I didn't cave in to that. And I have finally come to the place that I recognize this is in fact a journey. I realize that's what everyone calls it, and I even called it that in my initial video, but I did so for lack of a better word. To me, in the beginning of this journey, the word journey, in fact, sounded too dramatic to me. And it made it sound like this is such a huge, big deal. And I have to be honest with you, I went into this thinking it wasn't a big deal. I was going to grow it out, get some new products, and go on my way. And then I started thinking of what a journey really means, literally, versus a trip or, you know, traveling. Journey has a whole different definition to it. I think about if I'm going to the grocery store, I don't call that a journey. That's a trip because I don't pay attention to what's around me on my way there. I go and that's it. But a journey, you look at what's around you, you stop, you turn around, you might go a different direction. It's so much more about traveling or the process and more so than where you're actually going, if that makes sense. And that's what I've realized now. I am so in tune to my hair, and I have, you know, I don't know, an eighth of an inch of new growth, maybe, not even that. And I'm constantly in my hair, feeling it and seeing what it's doing. I have several coworkers who are natural, and I'm up in their head all the time, looking at their hair, asking them what they do. And I recognize that what I thought I was going to do in the beginning of this journey, because it's a journey, I started, not a good idea. Let me turn around. Let me go left. Let me change that. I have to say, I really appreciate all the very kind comments that people left. And they were very, very kind that people left when I said I was going to flat iron my hair for the duration of my transition. And you guys were so sweet, and you were like, I don't think so. Not a good idea. Are you sure about that? Okay. Good luck with that. And you were right. That was a horrible idea. I got my hair hot combed for the very first time. I've never had my whole head hot combed. And she did the entire head last week. And it was just horrible. And it wasn't that it burned or she got my ear or anything like that. It was just the thought of that. It was so harsh, and it was, it was too harsh. And I'm thinking my poor little teeny curls are being sizzled. And I sweated all out last night at Zumba, so it was really pointless. So anyways, what I've decided to do in this journey is that I am going to start doing more protective styles, as everybody told me to. I'm starting off with kinky, this week I'm gonna do a two-strand twist. When my hair was relaxed, I would do a two-strand twist all the time. And to make it really, really curly, I would two-strand twist it, then put it in a knot, and then clip the knot down. So I guess it's kind of my little janky version of the Bantu knot. That's what I intend on doing in the next couple days here. One thing that's different this time than when I did it when my hair was relaxed is I'm actually going to be concerned about the product I use in it. I think I used black gel last time, which is crazy when you think about it. So I'm going to do that this week. And then next week I'm going to be putting my hair in kinky twists. And I'm going to be leaving my hair up in braids for the next several months. And then at that point, hopefully, by the first of the year, I'll be at a place where I'll be comfortable with the big chop. That's the tentative plan. So I'm really excited about that. And I wouldn't have got to this place without all of your guys' amazing suggestions. And so I appreciate that. Additionally, what I've been doing is I've been taking biotin supplements once a day. And also, I don't drink milk, so I was concerned that I was calcium deficient. So I also started taking an additional calcium supplement. I haven't really noticed that it's helped, but it hasn't hurt. So I'll give you guys progress on that. I'm still researching a bunch of products and what recipe I'm going to create or what products I'm going to use. I would love to hear your guys' suggestions on that. And I really need your help coming up with what type of product or what should I use on my hair while it's in braids and in the twist. When I was getting my hair braided when it was relaxed, I would really just go buy whatever braid spray was cheapest at the beauty supply, put some castor oil in it, shake it up, and go on my way. And I don't want to do that this time. I actually want to make my own braid spray. So I would love to hear what you guys think I should do with that. You guys can look out for, I'm going to be creating a blog so that I won't be posting all the time, but kind of typing stuff, a little bit more interactive. I'm looking forward to that. And below, you can find my Twitter. Follow me on that. I'm a kooky person on Twitter sometimes. So yeah, that's where I'm at. I'm so excited about this journey, and it's about time, but I recognize that it really is a journey. So I'll be posting again in a few days. Take care, guys. Bye.